Sudden cardiac arrest claims 350,000 American lives every year. When every second counts, first responders need the most reliable equipment to do their job. PennCare presents the Philips HeartStart FRx, a rugged and dependable automated external defibrillator designed with the first responder in mind. Whether it's the police, firefighters, or even a sports physician, the Philips HeartStart FRx is ready to be used by professionals who are already equipped with AED and CPR training. Let's talk about how to properly use the Philips HeartStart FRx, when to use it, and how to care for the unit so that it is ready in case of a cardiac emergency. Keep watching to learn more. The Philips HeartStart FRx is not your ordinary AED. It's a tough, durable unit meant for use outside of home, office, or school situations. It can withstand a 500-pound crush test and also has a standby operating range of 32 to 122 degrees Fahrenheit. The Philips HeartStart FRx also boasts an IP55 rating. The IP stands for ingress protection, and the numbers indicate the unit's ability to withstand the elements. The first number means that it scores a 5 out of 6 for its ability to keep dust out of the device, and the second number indicates a 5 out of 8 for water resistance. Currently, this rating is the highest you can find for a commercially available AED. The Philips HeartStart FRx's construction means it's an ideal unit for placement in a police cruiser, fire truck, or anywhere that it could be utilized by someone with AED and CPR training. But at just 3.5 pounds, it won't weigh down any first responders who may have to travel on foot or over rough terrain to reach the victim. The device is also suitable to treat cardiac patients of any age, from infants to adults. The HeartStart FRx AED uses Philips' patented quick shock technology to minimize chest compression interruptions, and the device's smart pads sense application to the patient's skin to intuitively align with the response process. A shock is typically delivered just 8 seconds after CPR. In order to perform the initial setup, first, remove the HeartStart FRx from its packaging. Then remove the smart pads from the packaging and plug the pad's cable connector into the connector point on the FRx unit. Next, open the battery package and place the battery into the battery compartment. Press firmly on the latch until it clicks into place. Then set the FRx and pads case onto a flat surface and allow the device to run its automatic battery insertion self-test. The FRx will say, "Shock button test," and prompt you to press the shock button. Next, the FRx will say, "On-off button test," and prompt you to push the on-off button. Push the on-off button when instructed to do so. When the self-test concludes, the unit will report the results and then enter standby mode. The ready light will start blinking green, showing that the HeartStart FRx is now ready for use. During a cardiac emergency, it is important to act quickly but calmly. The HeartStart FRx AED should be located in a high traffic area for ease of access and routine checking. Someone suffering from sudden cardiac arrest will not be breathing normally and will not respond when touched or shaken. If there is more than one responder available, have that person contact emergency services while you set up the HeartStart FRx AED. If nobody else is available, contact emergency services, then get the HeartStart FRx AED. Press the green on-off button to turn on the HeartStart FRx. The device will direct you to remove all of the clothing from the victim's upper body. Then, remove the smart pads case from the unit's carrying case. Dry the victim's skin to ensure good contact of the smart pads. Shave off any excess chest hair if necessary. Peel off the backing to expose the adhesive surface of the smart pads, and then place them exactly as shown in the HeartStart FRx manual. Pay close attention to any lumps or surgical scars on the victim's chest. These could be indicators of an implanted defibrillator or pacemaker. Avoid placing the pads over these areas. The HeartStart FRx will start analyzing the victim's heart rhythm as soon as the pads are attached and the pads icon will turn off. The caution light will begin flashing as an indication that nobody should be touching the victim. If a shock is required, the caution light will change from flashing to solid. The orange shock button will begin blinking, and users will be prompted to press the button to deliver a shock. Before pressing the shock button, make sure again that nobody is touching the victim. The HeartStart FRx will apply the shock and then announce that it is safe to touch the victim to begin CPR. If CPR instruction is needed, the user can press the blue I button to receive coaching from the device. If the HeartStart FRx determines a shock is not needed, the device will alert the user that it's safe to touch the victim and begin CPR. If the victim starts moving or regaining consciousness, then obey local safety protocols until emergency medical services arrive. For treatment of an infant or child victim, First, begin CPR while an available person calls emergency services. If nobody else is available, perform CPR for 1 to 2 minutes before retrieving the HeartStart FRx AED, unless you witness the child's collapse. The HeartStart FRx has an infant child key, which is available separately. To use the infant child key, insert the key into the slot at the top center of the front panel. The pink portion of the key will pivot into the slot while the front of the key lays flat across the front of the unit and displays the infant child pad's placement diagram. When the key is inserted into the unit will announce infant child mode and will automatically reduce the defibrillation energy from the adult dose of 150 joules to 50 joules. The CPR coaching will change to infant child coaching. Remove all clothing from the child's torso, as the pads will be placed on the child's chest and back. Place one pad on the center of the chest and the other in the center of the back, as directed in the HeartStart FRx manual. If the child victim is under 55 pounds or 8 years of age, but you do not have the infant child key, turn on the HeartStart FRx and follow the unit's instructions to remove all clothing from the child's torso. Place one pad on the child's chest between the nipples and the other pad in the center of the back. There are certain situations where the HeartStart FRx or any automated external defibrillator should never be used. If the victim is in water or excessively sweaty, the device should not be used. It should never be operated around oxygen containers or other combustible materials, and you should never attempt to use the HeartStart FRx AED on yourself. Philips is the industry leader in AED devices, and the HeartStart FRx is specifically designed for first responders with CPR training, such as police and firefighting personnel. The package includes the HeartStart FRx device, battery, one package of smart pads, the owner's manual, and a quick reference guide. The HeartStart FRx performs a daily self-check to ensure all systems are operating properly. No manual calibration of the device is required. As long as the green ready light is blinking, the device is ready for use. After using the HeartStart FRx AED, check the outside of the unit for damage or dirt. Cleaning should be performed with a soft, damp cloth and soapy water. Ammonia-based cleaners can also be used, or a mixture of 2 tablespoons of chlorine bleach diluted in a quart of water. Never use rubbing alcohol, acetone-based, or enzymatic cleaners to clean the HeartStart FRx AED. Do not submerge the unit in any liquids or allow liquids to spill onto it. Sterilizing the HeartStart FRx AED or any of its components is not necessary. Make sure to replace the smart pads after use and record their replacement in the maintenance log. Additionally, do not store the HeartStart FRx with the infant child key inserted. Unless your local protocol dictates otherwise, remove the battery for 5 seconds and then reinstall it. This will initiate the device's battery self-check and confirm its readiness. Check to see that the green ready light is blinking and return the HeartStart FRx to its normal storage location. The HeartStart FRx AED stores data automatically for 30 days following its last use. This data can be transferred to a computer or device for review using the Philips HeartStart Event Review Data Management Software. Obey local safety protocols concerning the handover of that data to the appropriate medical personnel. The last use data stored includes ECG recording for 15 minutes following application of the smart pads, the status of the FRx device for the duration of its use, the FRx's rhythm analysis decisions for the entire incident, along with the elapsed time associated with the entire event. Periodic maintenance of the HeartStart FRx is minimal, but be sure to regularly check that the green ready light is blinking. Check any spare accessories for damage and replace any that are expired. Inspect the outer casing of the unit for cracks or damage. If damage is present, contact Philips Technical Support for assistance. All regular maintenance checks should be recorded in the inspection log. It is recommended to have a spare battery and spare smart pads with the HeartStart FRx, and these can be purchased separately. It is strongly recommended to purchase the infant child key, especially if the device will be in a setting where children are present. Other suggested accessories include scissors for cutting through clothing, disposable gloves to protect the user, a disposable razor for removing chest hair if the pads cannot make good contact, a mask or face shield to protect the user, and a towel or wipes to dry the skin for good pad contact. These items are available in a Philips Fast Response Kit. No other commercially available defibrillator can match the HeartStart FRx AED's durability and resilience. In accordance with federal law, the purchase of this device is restricted to physicians or a physician's order. Unlike other manufacturers' devices that only escalate to higher current levels if necessary, Philips' unique capacitor technology applies the highest peak current in the first shock. Avoiding the unnecessary escalation process means a victim receives the fastest treatment possible when seconds count. For more information about the Philips HeartStart FRx AED or other reliable Philips products, contact PennCare, your trusted leader for emergency medical supplies, software, and equipment. Please remember to give us a like, leave a comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.